The Minnesota North Stars. And what a young goaltender this guy is. Don Beaupre, he's won both games that he's played. And he is a good one.
A little worry about him before the game. He took a shot up high around the collarbone. We thought he was badly hurt. Apparently he's okay, but we'll be watching him closely. And we'll pick up the players as we go. And once again, it goes into the Rangers end to the right side of Eddie Mio.
That's right. Eddie Mio starting in goal for the Rangers tonight. John Davidson is still in traction, I believe, in Lenox Hill Hospital.
Backhand it goes in from Don Maloney. Beaupre to left side. There's Don again. Kotorik in front to free puck. Rangers cannot get to it in time. And the North Stars will send it up on the wing. Intercepted cleanly at the right sideboard. Rangers have it center. They should be onside here. Nice poke check. Knock it right back out again towards center zone. Check by, taken away by number three, Fred Barrett. And there's a penalty coming up right away. Barrett got his glove up around the face. One man. They started to go. And let's see how they're going to call it.
Donnie Maloney is going to get a penalty for cross-checking here. Barrett was holding on to him, and Donnie cross-checked him and put him down. And Barrett gets a, Don Maloney gets a penalty with that. Watch this now. Here comes Donnie Maloney. He comes around. Now watch number three right there. Look at him grab. Donnie lets go. Barrett took his glove off. And Donnie got up and give him a cross check in the back. So Minnesota goes on the power play for the first time tonight. And their power play is 35%, second in the NHL.
Look out.
That is good.
We'll pick them up as they come down ice. Brian Bellows, the highly touted rookie, wears number 23. He's on the power play. Number 15, another great rookie a couple of years ago, Bobby Smith. And does he shoot the puck? Back out it comes to the point and sent a little bit deeper. Bellows on the right side. This is Smith with the puck. Smith moves into dead center. Did not get a clean alley to right side now. Maxwell shot. Save! And wide on the rebound. That was a beautiful leg save. He was partially screened and had to make the last second adjustment. Left point this time. Back to Maxwell, right point. Maxwell looks for an alley. Can't find it opening. Left point. There's the shot. Save. And he'll hold.
Well, so far, Eddie Mio, who is starting his 30th game as a Ranger uniform, made two excellent saves so far this year. He's only won one game and lost three, and that goals against average is deceiving. He had, what, 8 goals scored against him in Montreal, and it could have been 16.
Yes, it could. 18 minutes and 42 seconds to go. Period number one. The power play still has a long time to run, a minute and 15 seconds. Face off on the right side of Mio. I think that's Neil Broughton in the circle. He has his back to us. A little tough to spot against Ron Duguay. Pavlich in motion, number 40. That was Broughton. Duguay gets the draw. His wing has the puck up the sideboard, but not clear. Up to the right point again. They have made some changes here. Number 17, Tim Young on right point. Pass to the goal line. Wraparound shot in front of save. And the puck goes the length of the ice.
Boy, I hope the people got a good look at that, the way that Broughton came out of that corner and was going right around. What I liked was that other guy on the far point, who was Cicerelli. He was right there.
Cicerelli wears number 20. He's going to left point now at the red line. Meantime, it goes into the Rangers' end, and they will chase it back. Tom McCarthy, number 11, on Dave Maloney. Rangers had the puck. They should clear. They got a 2-on-2 here. They work it quickly. Ron Duguay drops it back to Pavlich. Duguay sneaking in from the right side. Pavlich has the puck. He's got it in front. And poke check away.
What a fantastic play by Craig Hartsburg. Poke checking Mark Pavlich just in time.
Just in time. Cicerelli sends it in. Eddie Johnstone at the goal line. EJ lifts it high. It goes all the way the length of the ice and just to the right side.
There's only 10 seconds left in this penalty, Jim, and the Rangers have done a good job, although Minnesota has had a couple of opportunities. Ed Mio has come up big.
Rangers never budge in that box. They just stay there. Penalty is over. Don Maloney comes out. Free puck, Rangers end. Maloney is at the head as they go down across the red line. Don takes the puck of the pass from Johnstone. A shot's a high one. The rebound's in front. Free puck in front. Rangers can't get a swipe at it. And Minnesota picks up the puck in its own end. That's Vitorek doing the forechecking very tightly on Bobby Smith. Pass out. Across the red line. Little flip shot into the corner. Don't see too much of the dumping like that anymore. Beck's got the puck. Ritsalainen on the sideboards. Lost it on an easy check against it. Beck makes him pay the price. Free puck, Rangers in. Good check by Fatora coming back on Smith. And the Rangers should be able to get it out. It missed Johnstone on right wing. And it will go the length of the ice, but no icing called. As Minnesota loped a little bit going back.
Kind of a little mismatch there, but Fatora took him out very well, Bobby Smith. Bobby Smith standing about 6'4".
6'4", that's right. Arkansas is in now. They will carry out themselves. 23 is Bellows. Puck comes loose. Rangers trying to grind along the boards. Look at Beck come in. Put himself down with that check. Beck trying to stake out some territory early in the game. Shot is high and wide. Flory just does keep it in along the sideboards. Beck's got a shot. Save! Clear into his right corner, back to Beck. He shoots again off a stick. And Minnesota tries to break on a 3-on-2. They'll get a 2-on-2 out of it. Rangers intercept. It doesn't make any difference. Good cover by Dory that time. Rangers go in deeply. And Eric Anderson went down there. The body work is getting hard. That's Mike Eaves, number 18, behind the net. Good check by Dory. Rangers cover right point. Sent in a little deeper by Baker. And now Minnesota comes out. No score, first period. The Rangers end. Up ahead. Good solid check that time. Flanahan taken out with a hip check. Lennonen drops it back. Looks for the return pass behind the goal line. McClanahan overskates the puck and takes a hit. Checking him, number 14, Jordy Douglas. McClanahan steals. They got Lennonen in front. McClanahan can't get it out. He's smeared against the backboard. Rangers putting on some good checking pressure here. And they're coming in on from the point and doing a good job of sending the defenseman in. That was Tom Laidlaw in deep that time. Pavlich working along the boards. Pavlich tries to get it free. They do get it free. McClanahan pokes it ahead, but can't get it out in time.
Well, McClanahan got away with a hooking penalty there.
Took his man right down.
Oof. Boy, non-stop action.
No whistle, and finally get one on an offside. 14 minutes and 52 seconds. First period, no score from Madison Square Garden. This is New York Rangers hockey. Back here at the Garden after the faceoff, it's in Minnesota's end. The cross ice pass in front of the crease does not connect with the Ranger. And it is back to center zone. Eddie Johnstone. Johnstone with Petorek and Tom Maloney, the front line. Dave Maloney on back left side. Working out with Tom Laidlaw on right. Into the Rangers' end. It's going to be a shot here. Save off Cicerelli. He did not get good wood to that one at all.
But he made a good play there.
In front. Hook checked away. Nice defensive maneuver by Laidlaw. Johnstone on a break. Two men hooking him. Gets free. Two men on him now. Driven into the backboards. Taken in hard. Penalty. Little hold.
Well, I'll tell you.
14 minutes and 3 seconds to go. In the first period, there is no score, and the Rangers go on the power play for the first time.
We're back. Gordy Roberts gets 2 minutes for holding, and watch this. Right here, he's got two guys. Look at the tackle. He didn't call a penalty there. He still didn't call a penalty. Now Eddie falls down. Now he called the penalty.
Meantime, Rangers power play has begun. Ruotsalainen, left point. This is Anderson. Back to Ruotsalainen, the blue line. He passes to right point. Hedberg. Sent in deep by Lennonen, not deep enough. It comes back out again. Lennonen working the right side, Ruotsalainen the left. Rangers in their own end. Plenty of time in the power play. A minute and 34 seconds. There is no score. This is Hedberg. Anders to the blue line. In close. Pavlich didn't miss that shot. There was an excellent check on him by Brad Maxwell. Hit his stick at the same time Pavlich went for the puck.
Rangers power play is only 15.8. They're 18th in the league. Not good.
Hedberg. Pass did not connect with Ruotsalainen. Right back into Minnesota's end.
And that's why Minnesota North Stars are probably 6-1-1, and the Rangers are 3-6.
Long shot plays in. Another reason why other teams can play the body so effectively against the Rangers. The Rangers retaliate, and they can't take advantage themselves when they get a power play.
If you don't score in a power play, other teams will take advantage of it. They say, well, it doesn't matter whether we hit these guys or not.
12:50 to go in the period. Power play is still on. In deep. Ruotsalainen at the wing. They've got a man in front in the slot. Beck is at right point. Johnstone with the puck. Johnstone in front. Deflected. Wide. It went through the crease. Penalty coming up. On interference.
I don't know. I think he's calling Don Maloney an interference. I don't believe this.
I didn't see it, so we'll have to wait. What?
It is Don Maloney. I can't understand that one. I don't understand that call at all. I've been very good at the referee so far this year. Now watch this. Okay, there's Barrett. He and Barrett are hitting each other pretty good. He still hasn't called it. And there it is.
When he got in Barrett's way, with Barrett not playing the puck.
Yeah, but they're in front of the net. Oh, no, 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 Jim. Not this time. That was not a penalty.
What Phil's responding to now is a raised eyebrow. I'm looking at him.
That's right. He's looking at me like he's saying, well, Phil, I mean, it looked like it to me. It's Herb Brooks. And there is the Minnesota coach. We just saw Glenn Sonmore. He's a great hockey player in his day until he lost an eye.
In 24 seconds, the Minnesota North Stars will have a power play. Beck trying to eat up some time here. He's onside, close. Pavlich, Beck's in front, lost the puck though. One on one. Minnesota coming down the right side. 25 is McAdam out in front. And their referee had his hand up again. Just a stop play though.
There's Al McAdam. He is one of the first guy, or he's one of three guys left from the merger. The other two are Eves and Melosh that came over from Cleveland, started with Philadelphia, went to Oakland, then to Cleveland. And then when Oakland moved to Cleveland, and when Cleveland disbanded, Minnesota Louis Nanny kept Al McAdam along with Melosh and Eves.
25 goals a year from a working hockey player is a pretty good payoff. 4 years straight, not bad.
Yep.
8 more seconds, Minnesota will have the power play. Maxwell has the puck and sends it a little bit deeper. That's Smith taking a bump. Rangers had the puck, few games away. Pavlich, score!
Mark Pavlich gets a shorthanded goal on a great play by Ron Duque. And there's Mark Pavlich going to the bench being congratulated. Wow, what a beautiful shot. Watch this. A nice pass by Duque and a beautiful snapshot over the left glove of Don Beaupre. Mark Pavlich from Ron Duque.
It is a shorthanded goal at 8:02.
Duque is the only one that gets an assist on that.
Meantime, Minnesota is now on a power play. Puck in the Rangers' end. Hard bump by Laidlaw. Smith is waiting for it to pop loose. Number 15 with his back to you. He's got the puck now. Duque with a good sweep in front. Knocked that away. He's almost out in the crease area. Look at the Rangers stay in that box. Four men. Boy, they're inside. Dave Maloney doing some high stick work. Two North Stars in the corner. Two Rangers now as Anderson broke off number 24. There's Laidlaw again. Anderson doing the work in the corner. Anderson holding the puck in, wasting the clock. Stars have it now. At the goal line, coming back to Maxwell. He had trouble getting a handle on it. Sends it to his wing, intercepted. Rangers breaking Duque. Pass off the board. Duque goes deep. Look at Beaupre come out. The pass was not quite the right angle off the board. Didn't come out towards center enough. Meantime, here comes Minnesota again. Rangers lead 1-0. They're in deep. Left side is Steve Payne. There'll be a point shot. He's made the save. Payne and Duque. Payne gets loose. Back to the point. Maxwell feeds his wing in front. It just missed by Smith. He took his eye off it. Back out toward the point. Power play will end in 3 seconds. Maxwell, dead on shot. Kicked wide. Did not get to the goaltender. And cleared the length of the ice. There's Don Maloney out of the box. He got it. Kicks it in front. And we will get a whistle to stop play. 10 minutes and 25 seconds to go. First period, 1-0 Rangers. You're watching Rangers Hockey on Madison Square Garden Cablevision.
Robbie Fatorik right there. Good, hard-nosed young hockey player. I call him young. Mark Pavlich, that's his fifth goal. That's the most on the Rangers. And that's a third shorthanded goal for the Rangers this year.
Years go by, you'd be surprised how many young hockey players you'll find. At the red line, Fatorik breaks loose. Fake the screenshot. Holds on. Right out in front. Don Maloney going in close on Craig Hartsburg. This is Hartsburg number 4. Check by his own man. John Stone save. Rebound. High and over the glass. Oh, a collision in front gave the Rangers a gift, and it's not quite Christmas time for John Stone.
But a good save by Beaupre as Hartsburg coming around. He runs into his own man right here. You can see his right skate. And watch Eddie Johnstone. That was Broughton. He shoots one. Beaupre makes the save. And then the puck is a little bit too far over, and it goes up into the crowd. Eddie tried to put it up in the short side. There's a good look at that Don Beaupre, who is one of the good young goaltenders in this game of hockey.
Halfway through the first period, Rangers lead 1-0. Beaupre makes the stop off the backboards and leaves it for play. Minnesota coming out in style on the right side. Cicerelli at the red line, waits for something to develop. Passes to a wing just coming in and return pass looking for Ciccarelli. Mio takes a chance. Pass Ciccarelli back to the point. Barrett can't get to it. Rangers are there first. Ruotsalainen takes a hard check and goes down. Shoulder high, just upset his center of gravity. This is Hedberg. Ruotsalainen coming in. Takes a hook, shakes it off. Backhand save. Good shot on the backhand.
That's Freddie Barrett, number three of Minnesota. You watch him out there, you people at home. He gets away with murder with the hooking and holding.
Why do some people get away with it?
Because that's his style of play, and everybody gets used to it, so they don't call it. And that's a fact. I used to get away with murder in front of the net.
In front, just missed by Petit, making his first shift on the ice tonight. Shot. A bullet. Up high, off the glass.
That's how you know why Dino Cicerelli has 9 goals so far.
What a drive that was. Rogers with Duguay and Petit now. There's Allison completing the change. Allison with a puck in front. Missed by Duguay. Allison, a good setup. This line worked last night out against the Islanders. 8:30 to go in the first period. Everybody's sort of confused, like they're not sure if they heard a whistle or not.
I didn't hear the whistle either. Nick Fetillo has been, in my estimation, one of the better Ranger players in the last 3 or 4 games. You can see he has 2 goals in his last 3 games. He didn't play much last night in the island. I guess he got about 6 or 7 or 8 shifts apparently.
Great cover story in hockey news on him. He talks about how he traveled the subways at night and kept a hatchet in his bag. And he said he had to use it once. He took it out and said, a lot of crazies in New York, and they didn't know I was one of them.
Well, Nicky is, he grew up around here, of course, in Staten Island, and if anybody loves the New York Rangers, it's that man right there, bro.
8.5 minutes to go, first period. Rangers lead 1-0 on a shorthanded goal by Mark Pavlich at 8:02. And the delay, they had picked up something from the ice, had to clear a stick or two away now, the Grafanti said. Three puck, Rangers in. Laidlaw, shots on goal are 5-5. Duguay cruising in, can't get to it in time. 14, Jordy Douglas ahead. Rangers are playing defense at the red line. Dave up ahead. Missed by Duguay. And in deep. Solid checking behind the net. Tim Young, 17, throwing his body a bit. Back out to center zone. Down across the blue line and back behind the goal line. Mio will make the stop there. Lays it up to his wing. Petillo on the wing. Dave Maloney. Dave to Allison. Mike down the right side. Duguay takes it in his own end. Lost the puck in a backhand pass. Good check by Rangers. Far side, and Allison comes up with it again. His line's been out there a long time. Allison with a little deke. Almost got away at the red line. And sent ahead by Brian Bellows. 7:32 to go. Quick snapshot off the stick and up into the crowd. 7:29 now on the clock here in the first period. The Rangers on top by a score of 1-0.
We're back here at Madison Square Garden. Eddie Mio having a good first period so far. Shots on goal, 5-5.
At the blue line, sent toward the boards. Beck comes back. Beck turns it around the corner, coming back to the point. Blue line slap shot. He might have got a piece. It goes wide. Maxwell on the right side here, toward the net again. Beck trying to contain his man. Minnesota set up pretty good. There's Giles. Giles shot, broken stick, stop. Pavlich broke his stick with a check out in front. Beck off the sideboard. Minnesota pressing the action deep in the Rangers' end. They're looking very dangerous here. Beck trying to take some steam out of Alec Adam. Giles lost it back across the blue line. Pavlich has a new stick to work with. And again, this is Maxwell. Ruotsalainen plays the board softly and clear. Stars completing a change on the left side. Maxwell still in. Giles has gone to the bench. There's number 4, Craig Hartsburg, the captain. And Beck. Beck to McClanahan. Robbie gets away from the hook and lost the puck. 23 goes down. Brian Bellows wearing Lunani's old number. Shot toward the net. Goes wide. Comes back out left side of Beaupré. On the goal line again. Score is 1-0. New York over Minnesota. 6:13 to go first period. Maxwell almost lost in a stick check. McClanahan going for him.
It's a good point. Brian Bellows wearing Lou Nanny's old number. First round, first round draft pick. And Louis makes sure he wears 23.
Neal handling the puck well behind the net. Here's a shot from the point. Deflected a little bit, but he had it in front. We'll call it a save. Number six back to the puck, Bill Baker. Rangers coming out. Hedberg wide on the right. Rogers with the puck. Kolchek just took it casually away from him. Craig Hartsburg.
Oh.
Oh, that puck went up in the crowd fast. I guess it's all right. Very close. 5:37 to go. And from Madison Square Garden, this is New York Rangers hockey.
The number one draft pick in last year's amateur draft.
Eddie made another nice stop. 5:30 to go. Don up ahead. It is missed by Johnstone. Sergeant number 22. Been in and out of the lineup a lot in the last few years. He had a very bad back that he couldn't quite find the handle on. He'd be playing well now. That's Katoric back checking. Laidlaw and Don, Dave Maloney back there. Two stars behind the net, a pass in front. Rangers have it. Solid body contact, without anything really rough going on. Both teams playing pretty good hockey. 4:58 to go. First period. Sergeant ahead. Neal has his hands up, telling his teammates an icing call will be made. Very important.
You made a good point. That's McCarthy right there. Also, Tom McCarthy was a first-round draft pick in 1979. So you can see what we're talking about. You made a point about Sargent and his back. If he's come back and he's playing like that, he's playing well, maybe there is hope for John Davidson and Ron Greschner. I think Ron Greschner will be back, and I'm hoping that Johnny Davidson also comes back again. I don't understand why they don't and they can't find out exactly.
Backs are so tricky, Phil.
Oh, really? I'm not a doctor. I don't know anything about that.
4:47 to go. First period. Giles with the puck. Young ahead. Tim Young. Mio hands it off. Comes back up on the wing. Rangers cannot quite get to it in time. Anderson could not work it out. Young behind the net. Minnesota's in good shape. They're going to hang it right out in the crease area, but can't find him with a pass.
The Rangers better get moving here because Minnesota's had the more of the play the last 3 or 4 minutes.
Ranger a little flat. Good observation, Phil. Here's Beck with a rush. A little dive at the blue line. Giles back. Rogers on him. Young couldn't hold the puck. Hope check at the blue line. Almost half a sweep with Dory taking it away. Anderson. Pass to no one in his own end. Here comes Petit. Crowd reacts right away. Meantime, Minnesota has the puck though. Maxwell going in. Offside call as his wing broke on the right side. 3:41 to go.
Here he is, Brad Maxwell. He was a number one pick in 1977. So you can see what we were talking about, how Louis Nanny and the Minnesota North Star organization has built this team. And he played with Barry Beck. He was Barry Beck's partner, if I remember correctly. Mr. Beck has been telling me some of those stories about he and Brad Maxwell.
Can you use it?
I don't think I can.
3:37 to go, first period. 1-0 Rangers, a shorthander by Pavlich. And puck's going deep. There will be no icing. Duguay trying to get away in deep. He's taken down in front. That puck hits Allison. Mike continue to work hard. Duguay stays in deep. Duguay knocks it away. Good forechecking by Duguay. Allison continues to work his tail off in the corner. Back out again. They try to break, and Petit missed a check. Look out. He almost wiped out Allison. On the right side, McAdam. Shot. Save. Rebound in front. McAdam drops it back. Payne with a puck. Back to the point. Barrett shot it. Blocked by Petit. And Barrett and Petit come together on the sideboard. Good block by Petit. Almost put his face in front of that. The crowd reacts.
They love Nick Fetir, don't they?
Meantime, Minnesota doing some pretty good forechecking here. Rangers having difficulty working out. Two on one with Fetir on the left. Allison Fetir can't get to him in time. Allison still got it. In front, Duguay shot stop. Rebound, Duguay wide. On the rebound, McAdam on the left side. Rangers with three golden opportunities.
Did you see in front of the net, Jim? Freddie Barrett, he just had a complete hold of Nicky Fetir, just holding on to him as tight as possible. And the penalty wasn't called. That's what I mean. Some guys get away with things like that because of their style.
Pavlich and McClanahan. Pavlich going deep. Pavlich behind the goal line. In front to shot. Missed. Pavlich was a perfect setup out in front. Lehninen goes for the puck again. He'll never have a better chance for a chippy. Puck on the right side of Beaupre. Time remaining 1:58 in the period. Little delay. Rangers have control on left wing. Man in front is Lehninen. Can't find him. Pavlich in front. And the puck is taken by Minnesota. Rangers leading 1-0. Gary Sargent off the side board, but not cleared. Rangers putting pressure on Minnesota now. And the penalty is coming up on a trip, and the Rangers are going to be short. With a minute and 38 seconds to go in the first period, power play Minnesota, 1-0 Rangers.
Actually, 2.5. They've have failed yet to get one.
Don Maloney gets it back.
In fact, the Rangers have a shorthanded goal.
That's Young behind the net. Young starts out. Across the red line. Puck goes in deep to the corner. Cleared off the sideboard. Rangers shorthanded here. Beck goes down to block the puck, and he did it. Don Maloney taking on two men that time. He's still angry from those two penalties called against him. 1 minute to go in the period as of now.
This is the last play in the first period.
Pass into the slot. Hartsburg sends one to the corner. Johnstone helps intercept the puck but can't get it under control. Back behind the net for number 11, Tom McCarthy. Minnesota's got a chance here. Shot. Outside the net. He got a piece, and I think it hit the base of the net for the post. Time remaining in the period, 39 seconds. Young off the sideboards. McCarthy to the goal line in front and missed from the far corner. They had somebody capped in the doorstep.
Cicerelli.
Kick save!
What a great save that was, boy. Wow.
25 seconds to go. And a frozen puck in the corner.
That was one heck of a save right there on Broughton as Hartsburg shot that puck. And number 7, Neil Broughton tips it. Watch this. McCarthy goes back into the corner. Now it goes right across. Cicerelli missed this one. Look at this. He missed it. And now the puck goes back to point. Broughton shoots. McCarthy deflected it. And look at that save by Eddie Meehl. When that puck comes in like that and deflects it, that is very, very hard for the goaltender to make a save. Right there, Beck is just delaying a little bit. Watch him. He'll take back the same stick. I'll bet any money on it.
It's like a three-card Monty player. I can't tell which is the red card. That's beautiful.
And you can see Medill, he goes over there. He knows it.
You can see the tape is worn off or used.
It's 23 seconds, but sometimes you need a little break, you know, need a little rest.
You're a very sneaky guy, Espo. You see a lot of things like that. You've done them all.
You betcha.
23 seconds to go. Bill pointed out before, Minnesota had taken a little bit of command. The shots on goal sure show at 11-6 now. Minnesota, look out there. He's all right. He threw a check that missed and nearly went out the exit. Duguay and Rogers fighting off one man. It's getting rough. A cross check by Dave takes somebody down. 4 seconds to go in the period. There'll be a shot here if they get time. No time.
You see Barry Beck there?
Oh.
He went into the bench. He dove at the guy, and the guy moved. Sergeant and Barry Beck went into the bench. That was unbelievable. Watch this. Watch number 22. Watch Beck. Now he gets out of the way, Sergeant, and look at Beck.
My Lord. What a terrible
right
place to
there.
Be. 1-0 Rangers.
Los Angeles later on the coast. Mike Aruzioni has joined me in the studio. And, Mike, a pretty good period of hockey. The Rangers looking very good. Minnesota showing good forechecking. How did you assess the first period?
Yeah, Minnesota did do a good job at forechecking. The Rangers came out pretty good at the start, and then Minnesota started to take control a little. But the Rangers got the bounce that they needed on a shorthanded goal. Mark Pavlich on a real nice play by Ron Duguay. You're going to see Duguay come down and make a real nice spin move, feed the puck over to Pavlich. Pavlich lets the shot go, and it looks like it might have been deflected by the Minnesota defenseman's stick. Watch this. Here comes Duguay. Watch a nice move by Ronnie right there. Keeps the body away from the puck. Now, there's the wrist shot by Pavlich. Might have been deflected. Beats Beaupre in the glove, giving the Rangers that 1-0 lead. Now, things people talk about in a hockey game, they always talk about that extra effort. The Rangers had some extra effort here tonight. Nicky Fatiu on a great play blocking the shot from the point. Watch the puck go back right here. Comes back out. Saved by Mio. Good second effort there in the dive. But Nicky Fatiu makes probably the play that everybody wants to see. Watch this play here. That's great second effort. That's the type of play that you have to have in order to win these close hockey games. And then Barry Beck playing a little Superman role here. Watch, it's a bird, it's a plane. No, it's just Barry making one of his patented hip checks. Watch this one. Excuse me. Let's get another defenseman. Watch that. Right there, someone else go over, but Barry jumped over and got back into the play. Teams are set to start the second period. Let's go upstairs now to Phil and Jim.
Jim, that check right there, Barry Beck really nailed his bench.
I was going to say, I bet in the dressing room there are a lot of talk from his fellow players. We're on a power play here for the Minnesota North Stars. As the second period gets underway with the Rangers leading 1-0, the power play only has a few seconds to go, about 10, I believe. Shot. Stop. Broken stick. Pavlich, it's the second stick he's broken tonight. Shot. Save. Rebound comes out near the broken stick. Shot. Save. He'll hold. Now he drops it off.
Well, he should have held on because Pavlich didn't have a stick. The guy should have been yelling at him.
Good point.
Pavlich is using that new aluminum stick. The shaft is aluminum and the blade is wood.
Shouldn't break off that easily.
No. It's a good stick.
Backhand, quick shot possible here. Nope, it goes too deep, and the power play is over. Rangers have five skaters back on the ice. Rangers in control of the puck as Eddie Johnstone sends one down. 19:04 to go. Second period is just underway. They're going to get a breakaway here. Coming down quickly, Tom McCarthy. Shot! Save! Mio very, very sharp tonight.
He is. He's challenging. And when Eddie Mio challenges and comes out and challenges, he's good.
Fedorik. Fedorik. Angle in front. Puck goes wide. They got Don Maloney set up in the slot. Dory to the wing. Fedorik trying to break loose. And did get away from Fred Barrett. Dory crosses all the way over to the far side from right defense. Hartsburg. Hartsburg sent it deep. This is Eves. He's got a man in front. Stopped by the goaltender before it gets there. Here's Payne in front and through all the way the length of the ice.
Boy, Eddie Mio, I was going to say, when he challenges like that, he is something. He's right on his game right now.
18 minutes and 9 seconds to go. Barrett's lost his helmet. Puck is in their end. Minnesota's in. Could be a shot. Stopped in front. Hard checking took Rogers out of the play. Into the Rangers' end. Hedberg, Minnesota on a full chain. Behind Rogers, he breaks after the puck. That's Anderson in there deep, number 24. Play on the sideboards. Rogers, Anderson's on his right side. Quick shot, blocked before, gets the goaltender. Good stick. Number 23 again, Brian Bellows. Hedberg. Played off. And here comes Anderson down the slot. Anderson across the red line. Anderson draws two men. Now one. Drop pass. Dave Maloney can't get the shot in time. Yes! It's in. Oh, a little half-speed shot that went through a forest.
I believe it hit number two, Kurt Giles' skate, or Anders Hedberg's skate. From my view up here, it looked like Kurt Giles, number two, the Minnesota North Stars. Watch this. Dave is going to blast this one, but number 15, Bobby Smith, checks him. So Maloney only gets half. Now watch his skate.
There it is.
Anders Hedberg's skate. And he could have been called very easily for directing. Watch the left skate turn. Ready? Right now. Watch it. You see that? That was a beautiful move by Anders Hedberg. I'm anxious to see who they give the goal to. I think they'll give it to Maloney.
It's funny, he wound up for a flash. He never got much on it. Here we go.
They're giving it to Maloney because if Hedberg takes it, probably that wouldn't count.
We'll give you the full assist in just a couple of minutes. It is 2-0 Rangers in the Minnesota end as they break down right wing. Petillo coming back on left wing. Left the puck for Beck. Beck to the red line. Cross ice for Duguay. And deep into Minnesota's end. Good play by Dave Maloney all the way that time, carrying deeply. Petillo missed most of that check. Duguay back checking. Trying to get in front of his man. There's Petillo back. Knocked away from him. Got blocked. It's in front. He's got it. It's loose and goes wide right. Duguay at right side. Mio making lightning quick moves tonight. Duguay being hooked as he comes out. Goes to the wing, left side. Gets around two checks and almost got through a third. They will change. 16 minutes, 24 seconds to go as the whistle sounds here in the second period. With the score now, New York Rangers 2, North Stars nothing.
What does a man of adventure do between adventures?
I play Exidy's Venture, the video cartridge that plays just like the arcade game.
Sharpens my reflexes.
Armed only with an arrow, you hunt for treasure, gold, diamonds, and it's not easy because you have to get past deadly monsters, goblins, snakes,
and dragons.
Play Venture on your ColecoVision, Atari VCS, or Intellivision video game system.
I hate dragons.
Dave Maloney, his second goal from Anderson and Laidlaw at 2:43. Rangers are ahead 2-0. Now, while we got a chance, I want to say happy birthday to Michael Ruggioni. It's his birthday tomorrow. He says he's only 28, but he sure looks a lot older.
Yeah, the business will do that to you. 16-17 to go here, second period. Deep in his own end, Fred Barrett, number 3. Rangers forechecking. Barrett still played that puck well off the boards, protected it all the way out. And back into the Rangers' end. Shots on goal, now 15-7 Stars.
Mike was 28 when he played in the Olympics.
At the red line, got away from Neil Broughton. Quick break in here by Pavlich. Pavlich couldn't hold on to it. From the sideboards, Pavlich takes the relay. In front, can't quite tuck it in. There he is in front. McClanahan right on the doorstep. Barrett takes him out. There's Broughton, number 7. For his Hartsburg. Pavlich, of course, a Minnesota native. McClanahan just behind Pavlich. There's Lennon in 28 on the far side. 15-24 to go. Pretty well played hockey game. Lennon right on the money with that pass. That's Katora gone on a chain. Lennon, good deep. Can't get her turned around. There'll be a shot by Dave. Save. Rebounds loose. Lennon. Both fingers down and out, but it's up and over the glass.
Wow, Dave Maloney makes a fantastic play, and Mikko Lennon missed the rebound. But Maloney, what a super play that was. And not with the shot, because he followed up. He followed up and he bumped into Beaupre and took him out. Here's the shot, a good save by that young man, Beaupre. And watch Dave. You
You're
see him
right
take him out?
Yeah.
That's a play. Now Dave, which you can't see, he stayed right on top of Beaupre.
Meantime, coming back into the Rangers' end now. The first real break for Minnesota this period. Kicked away. Laidlaw got back. Dave Maloney. Coming back up on the right side for Eddie Johnstone. Johnstone took Petorik down across the red line. And Petorik plays it in. 14-40 to go in the second period. 2-0 Rangers. Rangers have opened up very strongly here in the second period. Number 28 coming out to Steve Payne, rather, number 26 coming out. In front, just near to her side.
Well, Fatorik made a good play there.
He ever coming back. Here he is again, taking the relay from Johnstone. And just got away from it. Giles Check. If he hadn't, he would have been nailed hard.
That could have been dangerous. Kurt Giles is the fourth round draft pick. He's the only one, not a first or a second.
Long shot wide. Beck takes his man out. Brian Bellows in front and through center zone. It's 2-on-3 as the Stars get back on defense. Don. pass, not quite timed right. Bobby Smith has the puck, but he circles deep in his own end. Smith coming down the slot, trying to catch the Rangers on a change. Smith across the red line. Beck slows his man down. He unloaded the puck when he saw Beck, as a matter of fact. Back up on the wing and the length of the ice. This should be an icing call. 13 minutes and 32 seconds to go. And the icing is called at 13:30 on the clock for Madison Square Garden. This is New York Rangers hockey.
Hi, I'm Hubie Brown, coach of the New York Knickerbockers. We as a staff, plus the players, have been working extremely hard in training camp to give you the...
Mike Rogers, center iceman, is celebrating his birthday today. He's 28 years old, and he's playing his 250th consecutive game in the NHL.
Face off in the Rangers' end. The Rangers lead 2-0 over the Stars. Back behind Sargent, breaking his Hedberg. Hedberg gets through the check. Still fighting for the puck in the corner and gets it away. Hedberg on the sideboards is dumped on the far side and pinned finally against the boards, and Minnesota almost settled for a draw there. And they might yet, just because of the work of that one man. Good play.
Excellent work by Anders Hedberg right there. First he put on a burst of speed and got that puck before Gordy Roberts, number 10. And fought and really worked hard to keep that puck in that zone. And therefore Herb Brooks is changing him up. Look at Brooks. Right now he's asking Walter Kachuk about something. And Walter will get on the phone and probably call up here. And Sonmar, on the other hand, is a cheerleader behind that bench. Glenn likes to yell and scream and everything else.
Face off on the right side of Beaupre, the goaltender for Minnesota. 13:09 to go. Duguay, forechecking nicely against Hartford.
It was anticipation right there by Duguay.
It was. Coutillo runs his man. Coming out 14, Jordy Douglas. Shot toward the net. Save. Almost sneak through. Laidlaw for Dave. Center zone. Dave Maloney and Laidlaw seem to be playing solidly together tonight. Headman pass. Onside. Allison. He got a save out of it. Beaupre got a piece. Connolly coming up. It'll be against Minnesota.
And it's going to be number 3, I'll bet you.
In the slot. Free puck. Allison can't get it away. Whistle hasn't blown yet. I'm amazed. They generally fast whistle these things. But now we get one. 12 minutes and 22 seconds to go. Barrett goes to the score. 2-0 Rangers.
Freddie Barrett gets caught finally for cross-checking at 7:38. He's been getting away. At least he got away with it the first period. Watch the right of your screen. You see number 14 Ellison go flying as Barrett cross-checking right across the back. And folks, I'm going to tell you something. That hurts. Oh, I used to hate when guys did that.
2-0 to score Rangers. Power play for the Rangers. This is only their second power play. And it goes the length of the ice.
You know, Jim, when they did that to you, you hear yourself going, ugh.
Hedberg takes a check in his own end. Ruotsalainen dumps it off for him. Good checking here by the Stars. McAdam is in deep 25 along with Eves 18. And the Rangers really had to work to come out. Anderson deep. He's got two men in front. Can't quite find Pavlich in time. Pavlich to Leninen. Right point. Pavlich shot wide. Stopped outside the goal. Pavlich again. Pavlich on the backboard. Anderson trying to dig at it. Rangers have a free man. Nobody's in a slot. Anderson drifts through now. Anderson's in front. Anderson trying to hold his ground. 24. Puck goes wide. Comes back out to right point. Leninen again. Leninen lost. This is Eves. And Leninen gets it back, but Giles will recapture and clear.
I like what Anders Hedberg did there. After he passed it, he went in that slot and he had a good shot at it.
11:19 to go in the period. 55 seconds power play. Quick shot of Hartsburg goes wide. Leninen again. That's Young behind him. Nice play at center zone by Hedberg. Pavlich, they've got an onside setup, but Pavlich ridden out by two men. There's Johnstone behind the net with Hedberg. Nobody's in a slot. Johnstone now tippy-toeing around. Johnstone trying to hide on Beaupre's left side. Johnstone in the slot. They don't get the shot. Here it is, deflected. There'll be a race for it. Ruotsalainen tucks it deeper. Hedberg. Nobody in a slot again. Okay, Leninen drifting in, but he's in a long slot. Shot deflected by Leninen. And the Stars should be able to clear with 14 seconds in the power play.
Lehninen was way out, and he tipped that. And that obviously is a play that he and Weirawatch Lehninen have done over the years, probably in Finland. But you said it, Jim. You called it in the broadcast, the play-by-play. Nobody was going in front of that net to get into that slot. They had three guys in the corner with the puck, three Rangers passing the puck back and forth in the corner. I don't understand that.
The faceoff will be to the left side of Beaupre. Rangers are leading by a score of 2-0. Shots on goal are 16-8 North Stars. Rangers only have two in this period. North Stars have five.
You see, time remaining is 14 seconds, just enough time to get that draw back. Rogers will try to get it back, probably Dave Maloney, draw it on his forehand. And watch Don Maloney, number 12, go right into that draw. At least he should. Let's watch it.
Yep.
There he goes.
Try to cover up that puck. And we'll get away with it.
Well, Gordy Roberts put it, grabbed it with his hand, his left hand, and brought it under him. And Greg Medill blew the whistle. Now Maloney goes off. Rare Roots and Lennon comes back on. And again, with 7 seconds left, Rogers will try to do the same thing.
Yep. Roberts gets it back. It's a line and lost it. Back. Still in the Rangers' end. Beck trying to get it clear of that line and does. Johnstone was taken down at his line. Rogers is tied up and power play is over as they come in for a shot that is wide. From the point, screenshot, save.
Good save.
Ahead of the field is Rogers. He'll have to hold up the blue line. Johnstone pokes it ahead. And the Stars get it under control to the left side of Beaupre. Gary Sargent, 22. Off the sideboards and pops out of play with 9 minutes and 54 seconds to go, second period. 2-0 Rangers, and you are watching Rangers hockey on Madison Square Garden cable vision. Authorized by Madison Square Garden Production Incorporated, solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or the use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this event, including the imposition of a charge for you in the program without the express written consent of Madison Square Garden Production Incorporated, is prohibited. Face off at the blue line of Minnesota. And the score is 2-0 Rangers. Laidlaw. Almost hit referee Medill. Hughes on the wing. Takes out. Here's a shot. Dave Maloney. Save and bounces wide right. Petit. Stickhandles out of the corner. To the point. Dave to Petit. Backhand. Good pass. Dugay. Backhand. Save. Oh, nice series that time.
And did you see Barrett again? He just ran at Dugay and flipped him down. Boy, he gets away with a lot of holding and clutching and grabbing. But Ronnie Dugay is probably the only guy on the Rangers team I can see going in the slot. Watch Maloney to Nicky Petillo. Good little backhand pass. Dugay, a good backhand shot. But you don't see that often anymore.
Allison up high on Hartsburg here.
Couldn't believe it. They were going at it. This line, I liked what the way they work. One guy's always in front of the net. They're all big guys, that's why.
Dugay back. Free puck in the slot. Minnesota will come out. Coming down quickly. Because Bellows, quick shot deflected. Penalty coming up on the hold by Dave Maloney. He is gone.
That is unbelievable.
9 minutes and 16 seconds to go here in the second period. Rangers leading 2-0.
It's Dave Maloney in the penalty box. 2 minutes for a high sticking at 10:44. And now North Stars are on another power play.
And they have a good one.
Well, look, they're 33%. And they're second or third in the league. And on penalty killing, they're third in the league, and that's why that team is 6-1-1. Okay.
Round the point, quick shot, save me all. Shot, save me all. And the Rangers have the puck and will come out. Back behind the goal line. Penalty against the Rangers has a minute and 32 seconds to run. Stars keep the puck in play. From the blue line, screenshot, save me, oh! Rebound, Beck, clear to the right boards. Kept in by Sargent. Pass, shot by Bellow, save me, oh! And Pavlich is ridden hard into the boards. Oh, as he cracks. He's all right. Shot, dribbles wide. Mio really under attack here. To the point, Sargent across, right point, in the slot. Shot by, and kicked away as Smith gets it underway. From the point, right side, number five, Maxwell. To the wing. Beck trying to keep it clear in front, doing some slashing on Billows. Minnesota's got a good chance here. Sargent. Boy, is Beck working to clear the slot. Smith again. Beck goes after him in the slot, stop, save, clear.
Eddie Mio has sure put on some exhibition right there. Barry Beck got away with three cross-checking penalties. When he cross-checks with his strength, it hurts.
7:53 to go. In the penalty, 35 seconds. Here come the North Stars on the attack once again. They are onside. And it's off Don Maloney and up into the North Star bench.
Okay, 30 seconds to go in this power play as Eddie Mio. Coming up big, the North Stars are out shooting the Rangers 20-9. Oh, Max, that's a lot of shots.
That's a big difference.
That is a big difference. One thing for sure, though, Eddie seems to be kicking those rebounds out a little bit too much. I wonder whether he has new pads on.
Better watch.
Because when they're new pads, they're stiff, and that puck bounces off them very fast. I want to ask.
Hartsburg around behind the net. Comes up on right wing. Power play is still on for the North Stars for the next 15 seconds. And the puck goes into the Rangers' end. Beck comes back. Beck again playing the whole shorthanded series here. And it is lifted clear by the Rangers. Nice, soft, easy, high flip pass. Chews up the time. And the penalty is over. Hartsburg. Hartsburg across the blue line. Hartsburg's got a shot. Save! Off the post. He's got it behind the net. And the North Stars are trying to dig it loose. It will be frozen there. Look out.
Eddie Johnstone, Cicerelli, and it looks like Broughton.
Nothing's gone down yet. No arm raised.
No. But did you know why Cicerelli has 9 goals? You're going to see. Watch this. Hartsburg comes in. He goes to the outside of Dory. He froze Dory right there. Dory made a bad play, a good shot. Now watch Cicerelli, out of the air. Watch. You see that? He knocked that puck. And Eddie Mio touched it with his stick. Now Broughton comes in. Watch Eddie Johnstone take Broughton out. And the puck is frozen. Now Cicerelli digs, and Eddie Johnstone pushes him. Pushes him again, and then that was it.
We're back to live play now. Down across center. 6 minutes and 52 seconds to go. At Sargent, number 22, Sargent across. Both teams have 5 skaters on the ice. Tom Laidlaw. Up ahead by Patorik. McClanahan back to Dugay. Patorik in front, stable play. And goes wide to the right side of the goaltender. 6 minutes, 25 seconds to go. Rangers leading 2-0, second period. Shots on goal are 21-9, North Stars. Centering pass, doesn't quite get in front now. Save! A sprawling kick save!
Eddie Mio comes up big once again on a beautiful little save right here. Okay, now watch this play. The puck goes in, I believe that's McAdam. McAdam passes out in front, here's the shot, but look at Eddie. He was sprawling, and he kicked that out with his right pad. Good save, I believe, on McCarthy.
His face-off will be on the left side of Mio.
Like I said, when Eddie is challenging and he's sharp, he's as good as anybody in the game.
Bobby Smith in the face-off circle for Minnesota. 6'4", 210 pounds. But a lot of strength in that 210 pounds. On the right side is Maxwell. Maxwell behind the goal line. Edberg, solid collision on the boards. He and Giles. Stars beginning to press a little bit harder now as this game begins to wear on. 5:56 to go, second period. Good forechecking by the Stars here. They have a man in the slot, but the puck comes loose.
only the goaltending of Meli Miev has kept the North Stars from, I think, being up in front about 4-2 in this game. He's been outstanding.
22 shots to 9 for the Rangers. Bouncing puck wide of Mio. Three puck sideboards. Edberg comes away. He's been working the boards very well tonight. Anderson coming down the slot. Looking for Beck. Beck breaking into the corner. Beck and Bellows tied up there. Try to take Beck down and couldn't. Solid check. Anderson keeps it in play for the Rangers. Beck back on his feet. Beck working like a forward now. Beck in front. Puts it out and there's no Ranger in the slot. The center zone.
But I will tell you this. The guys on the ice playing are playing extremely well also, the Rangers. And they're saying, well, that's Eddie Mio's job and he gets paid to stop.
They are playing a good game tonight. Puts a lane all the way. Set up. Ruotsalainen in the slot.
Tell you something, Jim, that was offside.
You calling offside of that?
Yep.
Okay. Rogers poked away. Rangers still had the puck. McClanahan. McClanahan taken away by Hartsburg. This is Hartsburg with the puck, number 4. Onside, way up into the crowd. Corey went down after it. I'm not sure if he got a stick to it or not, but the puck is way up high anyway. 4:27 in the second period, and the score remains 2-0 Rangers.
Okay, we're back here at Madison Square Garden, 4:27. Watch Ruotsalainen. Let's see if we can see whether it's offside or not, Jim. Not from this angle, you can't, but he made a good move. He throws Kurt Giles. Comes in, he puts a little pass out to Hedberg, and Anders flipped it, and Cicerelli, coming back on a good back check, stopped it.
And the puck goes into the Rangers' end, back behind the goal line. Eddie Mio there lays it off for Dory. Dory cannot control the puck. Tries to control his man instead. Pavlich working the sideboards hard. Coming back out. Screen shot. Save. It goes wide. Solid check by Baker, and he is gone.
You know, Bill Baker has not seen that much ice time tonight. And as you can see, Cicerelli, Baker, put him down on the ice with a good check. I don't know what he's trying to get here. Watch Baker. He just pushed him down, and at least Baker showed me something, and he's got a lot of strength right there. Bill Baker gets 2 minutes for interference at 15:52, and now the North Stars are on another power play. They're 0-4, and they're just about due, and Herb Brooks is not happy.
Beck coming out on the ice, of course. He'll be working out there with Duguay and Laidlaw. Is that Rogers in the circle?
That's Rogers taking the draw.
To the right point. Sargent is on left point and takes the pass. Sargent and Duguay locked up in a battle for the puck. Comes free. Bellows drops it back. This is Sargent in front and through the slot. Shot score! Off the right side. Smith on the right side.
There it is. It was only a matter of time. Bobby Smith scores that goal on a quick snapshot. Watch Sargent, number 22. He passes it across Bellows, touches it, but it goes right by him to Bobby Smith, and Smith blasts his puck on the short side by Eddie Mio. And the North Stars are back in the game. It was only a matter of time. Here they are, the third best power play team in hockey. And they kill off all those penalties.
It took them only 18 seconds for that one. And as Bill called it to you, Sargent with one of the assistants, Maxwell the other. Rangers coming in. Anderson puts it ahead. Penalty as Anderson goes down on a check. A little hook or a trip. Looks like a hook call.
You saw with Cody Roberts. He was talking to Anderson. He was saying, why you diver? Because they know Kent Erik Anderson. He was with the North Stars until he came over here. And Gordy Roberts gets a penalty for this. You're going to see a good dive right here. Watch Anderson. He gives a little dive, but Gordy Roberts did have that stick between his legs and twisted it. 16-20 Robert, 16-23 Roberts for hooking.
Well, the Rangers have a shorthanded goal. They have a regular strength goal. They have not had a power play goal, and of course we've been saying that an awful lot this season. Three puck goes into the slot. Hartsburg with the puck. Hartsburg coming out. Minnesota shorthanded. Time remaining in the period. 3:29. Mio with the puck. Dave Maloney to Beck. Beck along the sideboard. Back out toward center. Rangers had the puck. Johnstone coming in. He's got help in front with Don. Shot, save, rebound. He's got it. It's still free. He doesn't have it. Back behind the goal line again. Right side, Hartford. It is lifted high up into the air and down the length of the ice into the Rangers end at 3:05 remaining in the period.
Well, a good 2-on-1 right there. A good shot by Eddie Johnstone.
Setup is in the Rangers end. Rangers have the power play. 1:19 to go on that power play. Rogers coming down. Rogers looks for help. Nice stick handling. Rogers behind the net. Two men in front this time. Can't find him. Beck off the board. Blast. Post outside the net. Rogers with the puck on left wing. Don Maloney in the slot. Beck. Dead on shot. Got it with a stick off the glass. Beck goes deep. He's scared Eves off the puck. But now the Stars recover and clear. Time in the power play. 50 seconds exactly.
Well, that Barry Beck must play 40-50 minutes a game.
Rangers on the power play. Johnstone ahead. He hit Rogers right on the money. Rogers is in. He's got help in front with Hedberg. Can't get the good shot off. Excellent defensive work against Rogers in front.
Yeah, good play by Kurt Giles. And he took Rogers out. Mike was going to pass that puck. He was not thinking shoot. You've got to think shoot on the power play.
25 seconds to go in the power play. This is Pavlich. Could not quite get around Eves without being punished a bit. Eves on the sideboards, and he did not clear the puck. Rangers have it at left point. Shot. Save. He's going to hold on to that one.
That was an excellent save. But Beaupre, look at Rayo Ruotsalainen. He is angry with himself. But he had a good shot there, right on the net. Nice and low. Watch this good shot here. Look at the Ranger bench. They're all standing up. Good fake. He faked. I believe it was 16 Anders Hankinson. Faked him right out. And a good shot and a good save right there by Beaupre.
It was.
He leads with the Rangers and shots on goal with 30 and with shots missing a goal with also I'd say 30 or 40.
Just a few seconds remaining in the power play. 5 seconds now. Baker having trouble. He could not keep it in play. Stars are breaking loose. That's Petrovic back checking. Roberts out of the penalty box. The puck stays in play. There's going to be a penalty against the Rangers.
I don't believe this penalty. This is a lousy call. Boy, boy. Greg Medill. I mean, that's all he's doing is calling one on one team, one on the other team. Watch this. Ronnie Fattori coming back. Now, this guy was diving for the puck to knock it over, and he got a penalty for holding. Now, Jim, I've been good so far this year.
You've been semi-good.
Okay, I've been semi-good, but I've got to give it to Medill. He's not having a good game.
Rangers will be shorthanded for the final minute and 29 seconds of this period unless Minnesota scores. It is now a tough hockey game. It is 2-1. Rangers by a one-goal lead. Coming back up on right sideboards. Rangers are trying to clear here and cannot. 2-on-1. Only Beck is back. Pass across, and it's too hard and through his man. Broughton again. Broughton got a shot. He passed instead. Save! And the rebound comes out off the right sideboard. Giles taken down. A call back into the slot. Hartsburg chops it down. Rangers will break. Only one man back. They're not quite quick enough. It's a two-man back. They still have the edge. Pass across is missed. It bounced over Rogers' stick.
Tim Young was back there in defense, and he's a forward. But Tommy Laidlaw was the guy coming down. And he's a defenseman.
44 seconds.
He would have known that was a forward. He could have gone in there a little bit more.
Yes, he could. 38 seconds to go in the period. Rangers leading 2-1. Second period coming down to a close. Minnesota has been denied by Mio mostly tonight. He is the one single hard reason. This is Young back with 27 seconds in the period. And down the slot and coming out. Minnesota, this is Broughton coming across the red line. Broughton lays it off on the left side. Dave clears off the backboard for Duguay. Duguay looks ahead, lost the puck, goes back, but he's got it. Lost it again, in front. Dave Maloney covering. Rangers again are breaking. They got a 3-on-2 here. Onside, broken up momentarily and lifted up into the crowd with 5 seconds to go in the second period.
Well, that guy, the defenseman there, I believe it was Giles.
Giles, I think.
knocked that puck right out of the air with a stick. With 5 seconds to go, Dave Maloney, you know, he has 9 goals lifetime against Minnesota. Of course, he got his 9th goal tonight. Having a good game, too.
Yes, he is. We haven't really talked enough how the Rangers had to change all their defensive assignments and pairings because of what happened before the season really got underway. And it's very difficult for a defenseman to work so long with one single man and get used to a different man. So that's the end of the period. And the Rangers in that period came up with, let's see, 7 shots on net for a total of 13. The Stars have a total of 23 shots on goal as we watch them go out. And at the end of 2 periods of play, the score is Rangers 2, Minnesota 1. You're watching Rangers hockey on Madison Square Garden Cablevision.
Oh boy. Okay, we're back here. There's the scoring summary right there. Dave Maloney.
But now it is Anderson who gets the goal, and we're not sure where the assist will go.
I don't know how Anderson got that goal, Jeff.
Nope, neither do I. But they have just given Anderson the goal. So we'll see what happens.
Because if anybody gets credit for that goal, it would be Anders Hedberg.
But then, as you pointed out, if he did, then maybe somebody would say he directed it in.
That's right.
We did have Anderson down as one of the assists, but heck, Dave, well, in any event, we'll find out.
Anyway, third period about to begin. Don Beaupre working back and forth in that crease. You see the goaltenders, they always like to scuff up that crease and about 15, 20 feet in front. And that's just to keep the snow there and the glare down.
Fatorik is still in the penalty box. We have a 5-on-4 skating situation with 25 seconds on the penalty clock. Mio again defending the goal to your right as you look down from high up atop Madison Square Garden with us. Payne on the far side. Going to be a dead-on screen shot. Save! Oh! Fast left hand.
That was a good glove save, but a little too high shot by Brad Maxwell. Watch his blast. You won't see him shooting. Yes, you will. There it is. And watch the left hand. Bam. Right there. Good.
Oh, look at Smith.
He was right on the doorstep waiting, wasn't he? There's a look at Brad Maxwell, who was Barry Beck's defenseman partner.
We're getting a new message on that goal. It will be Hedberg, not Anderson. Hedberg will get that goal.
I couldn't see how anybody else. Actually, I think Minnesota has a legitimate beef if they say that Hedberg directed it in.
10 seconds to go in the power play. Quick shot by Sargent. Up off the glass. It stays on the ice in the rebound. Three puck goes around behind the net. The power play will end in 3 seconds. It is underneath Tommy Laidlaw.
Well, there was two big guys hitting, Laidlaw and Steve Payne. As Beck was talking to Laidlaw. Tom is adjusting a little bit because he's back on right defense this year, which I don't think he's played much of. Last year he played left with Andre Dory.
2 seconds in the power play for the Minnesota North Stars. Rogers trying to get in position. He's got Beck on his left side, Duguay, and now Rogers goes out and Duguay will fill in. Face off left side of Mio. Point shot possible here. It is wide, not on target. Rogers at the right wing. Behind Duguay, Stars will capture. This is Maxwell. Maxwell along the sideboards, back to the Rangers' end. Laidlaw back to the puck. No icing or offside. Laidlaw has to bang into his man. Has the puck again. Double team back behind there with Brian Bellows and Smith. In front, knocked away by the Rangers' back checking and taken away neatly by Hedberg. Hedberg, Rogers, Duguay. Duguay shoots. Save.
He didn't know where that was.
He lost the rebound. But it comes back out to center zone. Baker. Baker around behind the net. Hartsburg could not get a handle on it, coming back out towards center zone again. Rogers backing. Baker. Bill fires across to Duguay at the red line. Hedberg waiting as Rogers goes in. Quick shot. Wide.
Oh.
What a blast. But wide. Not on target. Duguay centering. Hedberg couldn't get turned for it. Duguay again on the rebound. Duguay takes his own position in the slot, looking to return pass. There's Duguay. They got Hedberg in front. Hedberg missed. Rebound coming to Minnesota North Stars and back across center zone. feed on left wing. Cicerelli is deep. Cicerelli being bodied off the puck. Rangers have it in their own end. Rangers with a one-goal lead here in the third period. Hedberg pries it across the blue line. .17:58 to go. We are in the third period. Rangers with a one-goal lead. Nice work here all the way down by Gordy Roberts. Roberts centers. Hedberg is there. His final move is a bad one. Rangers are in deep. This is Pavlich. Pavlich wraps it around and puts it in front. The rebound. Oh! Two Rangers collided. One was Lennon, and he really dumped McClanahan. It was all right. Laidlaw back. Minnesota completing a change. McClanahan. Rangers in good skating form here. If they can continue down, they are onside. McClanahan poke checked away. Rebound lost by Lennon, and back to center zone. You could almost feel a break coming on that one. 17:15 to go, period number three. Bad pass picked up by Minnesota behind the net. McAdam with the puck. McAdam lost to Pavlich. Pavlich in the referee. McClanahan with Pavlich on his right shoulder. McClanahan deeks his way in and goes deeper. Waste some time waiting for help. Try to center a backhander and could not. Hartsburg with the puck. Hartsburg to his wing. Rangers completing a change. There's Petorik on the ice blocking their path. And back deep it goes behind the Ranger goal line. Ruotsalainen kept in. Hartsburg screen deflected. Stopped in front. Rangers will get to it. The 3-on-2. Petorik, good move. Offside. Bad move. Just off. 16:36 to go. 2-1 Rangers. You're watching Rangers Hockey on Madison Square Garden Cablevision. Off at the blue line of the Stars. Minnesota needs a goal for a tie. 16:30 to go, third period. Bouncing puck just wide of Beaupre. It might have tucked in. Called a shot on goal. Roberts trying to get it clear. Or, yes, Cicerelli is out there too. I occasionally get them confused in the distance. I'm sorry. Beck. That was Roberts. Beck. Long shot. Beaupre's there. Rebound. Torek couldn't quite dig at it. Robbie works the boards, could not get it free. Bellows ahead of the field looking for a pass. Sargent made a deke and Bellows goes offside.
That puck was still not brought over the blue line. And it was just a little bit of a quick whistle. Ken Solheim right there got traded. Blackhawks had him. Minnesota picked him up for Glenn Sharpley. And
make another choice named later, future Black, considerations.
Probably a draft choice.
Yeah, I think
Louis
so.
Manages to get.
He stockpiles a few, doesn't he? Gordy Roberts sends it in from left defense. 15:50 to go, third period. Rangers 2, North Stars 1. Headman pass to Hedberg. Steal by the Rangers. They got Rogers. There he is, just off the side of the goaltender. Rogers and Hedberg, two men behind the net. Rogers in a slot. Rogers, a short slot shot is blocked. Rogers trying to get it off and couldn't get Goodwood to it. Here's Rogers again. This time Anderson is in the slot. Back across the blue line. Going to take it away and across the red line now. Coming in on the pass from Bellows. And look at Eddie Neal.
Baker got hurt right there. He got checked by Bob Smith.
Baker trying to get to the Ranger bench. He's still doubled over. Crowd is calling for a penalty. There will be none.
That's what gets me. McGill lets so many little things go. I mean, flagrant things go then calls something that isn't even a penalty.
Look at Giles working his way in here. Nice play by Giles. A beautiful play coming back. That was Dory. Shot on goal. Saved by Mio. Dave Maloney. Dory takes his man out. Dave has the puck. Puts on the brakes and clears. Third period. Good, fast-moving hockey game. Dave again. Solid check by 11, Tom McCarthy. Nice rush by Pavlich, possible here. Lennon. Nobody in front. Now McClanahan is there. McClanahan has to break off. McClanahan in the corner. Pavlich and McClanahan, two on two in the corner. Lennon takes it away. In front, save! And on the rebound, he got a piece again. It went wide. Rangers getting their chances now. Pavlich at the goal line. Comes back out. Lennon's pass in front. McClanahan can't get a backhander away. Kept in momentarily, but not entirely. Lennon with the puck. Cross ice, looking for McClanahan. McClanahan and Hartford. Hartford erases him along the board. 13 minutes, 50 seconds to go. Good steal. And re-stolen, and the Stars come out. Neil Brott lost it. Patoric. Some good heads-up hockey play by both teams right here. And into center zone. Patoric with a check. Don Maloney draws a crowd. Three men around him. Patoric in front. Shot stolen. Kept in by the Rangers. Oh, good hockey to watch here. Giles off the sideboard. Payne with the puck. Boy, the Ranger pressure is making them cough it up.
The Rangers are playing extremely well right now. They're forcing the action. Something they didn't do really in the second period. Of course, they're a man short so often.
13:03 to go in the hockey game. On the sideboards, Rangers in. North Stars are down by a goal. We'll get a frozen puck right there. 12 minutes, 54 seconds remains in the hockey game. The score, Rangers 2, North Stars 1. Back in play in the Rangers' end. A good pass saved by Mio. Rangers come out. Hedberg trying to streak down the right side unmolested, but cannot get the puck in deeply enough. Anderson reaches for it and misses. This is McAdam, 25. At the blue line. Eaves are number 18. McAdam goes after the puck. It's lining at McAdam. Nice handoff from the far side to Payne. Payne lost it on a poke check and gets it back. Rich lining in the corner with Eaves. Minnesota will settle for a face-off there anytime.
Yeah, you always like to get a draw if you can in the other team's zone, especially if you're tired and all that. Boy, Rogers is very angry about something. Probably because he thinks that Minnesota forced the face-off and the puck should be brought out outside the blue line on the draw, probably. But he is angry about it. 28 years old today. Oh, to be 28 years old.
Allison, Duguay, Petit with this line. Duguay. Duguay. Petit. Onside and lost it on his backhand. Duguay continues in. Petit in the corner, rubs his man along the board. Dave Maloney sends one toward the net wide. Petit's on the other side now. Free puck. Only one defenseman back. Dave fell at the line. Coming in right side, Bellows centers it. In front, wide shot. Just wide of the net.
Allison, what a great play.
What a play
back
by Mike Allison coming back. Dave Maloney had been lost at the blue line.
Stripped his skate, probably.
Duguay, onside. Call it offside. We'll see that one again.
Oh, boy. There's Ronnie Duguay right there, but Mike Allison was the guy. Boy, Mike Allison, really, watch him. Watch on the right of your screen now. Keep watching. You'll see it. Bellows has a shot here, and he sees the guy on the left, tries to make a pass, and look at Mike Allison. Right with him. Excellent play.
That's covering your man.
That's plenty cocky right there.
11:15 to go in this game. Dory back. Andre along the sideboard to the blue line. Puck is stopped at center zone. Cicerelli going after it right wing. Back from Baker. Centering pass. Going to be a shot. No, Dory's got his man screened. Smith had one. Here's one by Giles, and he can't get it away. Boy, did they have two fine opportunities that time.
Yeah, they didn't shoot the puck.
That's right. Almost halfway through this third period. Roberts across to Giles. Cicerelli goes to left wing. Worked in deep. Rangers are back. That was being held a little bit. Whoa. Back to the point. Giles shot just wide of Mio. Got through him. Lennon lost it. Gets it back and finally plays center zone. Pavlich coming down with McClanahan. He's onside. Pavlich backhander. Saved by Beaupre. Pavlich behind the goal line. Rangers breaking in front. Wide. Shot by Baker. Wide. Rebound shot. It's a pass behind the net instead. Don Maloney. Lennonen. High. Oh, they missing the opportunities. They got them. The net has been open, and they have not been on target. Back across center zone. Broughton to Cicerelli. Eludes a hip check. Cicerelli sends it a little bit deeper. Broughton goes at the puck. Shot outside the net.
When you keep missing those opportunities like that, it always comes back to haunt you.
Petorik lost it offside on the right side. Johnstone off on right wing. 9 minutes, 35 seconds remaining in the hockey game. 2-1 Rangers from Madison Square Garden. This is New York Rangers hockey.
Back here, look at the difference in height right there. Steve Payne and Eddie Johnstone.
Don't tell Johnstone, he never knows the difference. He thinks he's bigger than everybody.
Steve Payne is 6'2". Eddie Johnstone is 5'9".
9.5 minutes to go in the hockey game. Ross Darcy to goal for a tie. Back to the point. Mark Burke from the point. Deflected. Petorik has a land on right wings. Johnstone, here he is.
Johnstone and a beautiful pass from Robbie Petorik. Excellent goal. Ooh, he watch this check. Don Maloney takes out Al McAdam. Look at that check. That's the way to take the man out. The puck comes out. Eddie Johnstone blocks it. Petorik, watch the right of your screen. Comes in. Watch his fake. To the left. Right here. And to the right between the legs. Right there. Excellent move. Right between the legs of Don Beaupre, the Rangers lead 3-1, 9:15 left in this game.
And we're back to live play again. This is Smith with the puck. Petorik on the assist. Mayo makes the stop, and it's just too bad they can't give one to Don Maloney for the block.
That's right.
Anderson ahead. This is Rogers. Rogers trying to find an alley and cannot find a route to the puck. Dave Maloney. Dave goes in deep, lost it. Rangers have a shot. Save! Dave right in front trying to screen the goaltender.
That puck deflected off someone and went up in a crowd. And boy, that's so dangerous. Oof. When you come to a hockey game and you sit by that net like that, behind that net, anywhere up in that area, keep your eyes on the play. You should always keep your eyes on the puck anyway in the play.
Like sitting down the baselines at a baseball game when the line drives come.
That's right. You've got to be aware. You've got to be smart and quick. But it's fun to be down there.
Shots on goal, 30-19 North Stars. Play is in there at 8:44 to go. Rangers by two. That was a pretty goal by Johnstone. Neil lays it off. Andre Dorey. Fellows four checking pretty tightly on him there. Solid check by the Stars. Beaupre out. They will have to take some chances now. They're down by two with 8:26 to go. Stars trying to break out, coming down right wing. Roberts across. Into the Rangers' end. Rangers have the puck coming out. Pavlik lays it behind him for McClanahan, who sends it in. Lennonen. McClanahan back to the point, and Dorey was going this way when the puck went that way. 8 minutes to go. In the hockey game, Rangers leading by two. Dorey, hip checked off the puck, center zone.
That was a good hip check right there by Hartsburg. That was a classic hip check.
At the red line, Rangers on a change. Not quite lined up too well here coming in. But Salina, though, does have Hartsburg under control. Shot toward the net, deflected. Broughton behind the net, Cicerelli. Baker goes after the puck. Good play that time on the right side. Weak side coming out. McClanahan coming back and sends it deep. Stars again trying to catch the Rangers on a change here. Solid check by Beck. And it is offside as a result. Here's the story. 7:21 to go. Rangers 3, North Stars 1.
Back here in Madison Square Garden, Anders Hedberg, one of the goal scorers tonight. By the way, that one goal he scored was his 99th NHL goal. One more for the 100.
7 minutes and 16 seconds to go. Rangers with a two-goal lead. Eves, number 18, anticipating coming in here on the wing. Look at Mio, he's out. He gets back in. Anderson back right in front of the crease. Almost lost it. He did. Eves drops it back. A shot is wide from the point. Ruotsalainen trying to get control here behind the goal line. Hedberg off the skate before it got to Ruotsalainen. Rangers are still taking chances and going deep with their defensemen. In front and through. Rogers with some body checking. Not strong enough. Beck is standing right outside the goal. Rangers clear this. No icing. Will be waved off. Rangers get a chance for a full change here. Defense in front. We're inside the 7-minute mark. 6:25 to be exact. Johnstone. Kept in on a bad pass out. Dave covers. This is Laidlaw. Don Maloney. 3-on-2. Don holds a long time. In front. Deflected wide. They had 4 men chasing Don Maloney. Johnstone shot saved. And the rebound goes wide. This is Roberts. Petorek staying in. Solid game for Robbie Petorek. Never stopped working, Philip.
No, he doesn't. He works hard all the time.
5:46 remain. Bellows ahead. Dave Maloney. Rangers are just eating up the clock with a lot of this pass work. And Petorek again. Lifts it high off the backboard, hoping to find somebody, maybe even himself in the rebound. Johnstone here on the wing. It's behind him. It's a 2-on-2 breakout. Smith. Dory stays with Smith. Smith lost his head.
Oh,
he almost got hurt on that. He went in feet first. That's an ankle job that time. That can really... He's all right.
Yep, he's all right. He lost his... Got in a rut there.
5:16 on the clock. Score remains 3-1 Rangers. You are watching Rangers hockey on Madison Square Garden cable vision.
And 16 seconds left in this hockey game. The Rangers are up in front 3-1. This is live from Madison Square Garden.
Dory on the sideboards. Play is in center zone. Rangers leading by 2. Eddie Mio lays it off to Dory. Off the wing. Pavlich can't hold it. They might have a shot here in the slot. Cleared by Baker. Dory lost behind the net. Shot toward the net. Wide of Mio. McCarthy, number 11, going for the puck. Cannot get there in time, but it's centered for Minnesota. Nobody wanted it for a split second there, but the Rangers get away and get back to center zone. Obviously an exaggeration. Sometimes they're just leaning the wrong way. Solid hip check by Dory.
And Dory got away with a penalty there.
Drop pass. Screenshot. Wide on the rebound through him. He got enough to call it a save, and the rebound carried wide.
Surprised me, but Mark shot from so far out on a 2-on-1.
He had time to move in. Hartsburg, he's moving in. He's surrounded, taken down. And puck goes up into the crowd with 4:04 on the clock.
A little talking right there, but nothing going on with it. Watch this drop pass. Now Mark comes in, Pavlich, and he shoots the puck. And a good stop right there, but watch the puck just trickle by that goalpost. So look at Mark Pavlich, who has scored 1 point in these Rangers 8 first goal. Boy, I didn't say that very well, did I?
You're getting to be your own best critic. That's great. 4:04 to go. You've arrived when nobody has to tell you anything. Sergeant sends it deep. And should come out. shots on goal. A little bit more respectable for the Rangers now. 30-21. They've been outshot all game long by the Stars. Sargent ahead. McAdam breaking in. Beck took him. North Stars had the puck. Rangers in. Payne is in front. Rangers being pressured deep. They will come out. Hedberg. Rogers onside. Ruotsalainen goes deep. Hedberg trying to find anybody. Rogers, it's back. There's nobody on the right side. Ruotsalainen had gone in. And Beck has to cut across. Anderson. Anderson sends it in. North Stars up ahead. This is Mike Eaves, number 18 to the red line. Got by Dave Maloney's check. High shot. I think Neil was screened. He reacted late to that. Not on target. Hedberg comes out on the wing. Anderson to the red line and ahead. Don Maloney. Don loses on a poke check. Laidlaw's got the puck. And Laidlaw sends it in. We're inside the 3-minute mark. Starting out again, Brad Maxwell. Maxwell, long shot, deflected save. That was as good a save as he's made all night long on a long-range shot. 2 minutes and 42 seconds on the clock. Rangers lead 3-1.
Eddie Meehl right there, I think is having one of the best games I've seen him have since the playoffs last year.
Spotted that early, Phil. You talked about him coming out, challenging, being aggressive. Shot toward the net, deflects wide, 2:38 to go. Rangers with a two-goal lead. Laidlaw plays the board. Took a Minnesota bounce. A bouncing puck goes in front. Laidlaw gets a second shot. Smith is on him. Rangers have some manpower on left wing. They'll be challenged and cannot cleanly get it along the boards. Still battling for it. Bellows, number 23 for Minnesota, takes a little shot from behind. A frozen puck, and the Rangers will have to try to capture a faceoff in their own end with 2:21 to go and a two-goal lead.
Well, they don't want to keep getting these faceoffs in their own zone because eventually it's going to burn them. And I remember a game when I was playing with the Rangers. We were playing, I think it was against Atlanta. And they had us 2-1 or something, and they kept icing the puck. And finally,
yes.
Remember that?
Yes.
Finally, we won a faceoff in their zone and finally tied it.
And New York is going to take a timeout here to discuss their kind of strategy. Just a quick reminder to you, stop by your participating Burger King restaurant in the New York, New Jersey, and Fairfield County area for details on special Knicks ticket offer.
I think right now what the reason for the Rangers calling a timeout is simple. They want to give Beck a little bit extra rest. There's 2 minutes and 21 seconds to go in this game. They want to give Eddie Meehl a little rest, and they also want to give the Minnesota North Stars something to think about, because they were coming on a little strong, and they have had three or four faceoffs in a row in the Rangers zone.
You couldn't be more right, Phil. I was watching. They didn't discuss strategy or anything else. He just stayed at the bench. Neil got a little shower.
We've always talked too, Jim. Why have to wait till the end of the game to take a timeout?
My favorite subject. Sometimes I think it should happen in this first and second period. The other team's coming on strong, especially when they just scored a big goal. You know they're going to be hot, and if you don't get a pass, if you don't can't slow down the line change, which most coaches don't do, you got a problem.
Exactly.
See, I would do everything legal to stall after the other team scores a goal, but so quickly they'll drop that puck right after the goal, your team hasn't fully recovered yet. Faceoff, left side of Meehl. This is a big one. Stars are two goals down, and Broughton has been talked out of the circle.
He's got to put his stick down first, apparently.
Rangers had the puck on the draw. That was Petorek winning a key draw. Dave Maloney coming out. He's got Petorek.
Robbie Fatorik on a beautiful feed from Dave Maloney, but that all started because Robbie Fatorik won that draw. And what a shot he made there. Watch his face off. Excellent draw. Look how he's down. Back to Dave Maloney. Maloney goes around the net, and he steams up that right side. And look at Fatorik. Watch his little pass. Ah, what a beautiful pass. And Robbie puts it over the shoulder of Beaupre, and the Rangers are ahead 4-1 with 2:09 left in this game.
Robbie Petorek, who was injured in the early part of the season, gets number one.
That all started with a faceoff. I like to see that, though. You know,
did he cleanly win that one or what?
That's right, he did. Dave Maloney made a great effort. A great effort steaming up that right side, Broad. I'll tell you, watch his face-off. Look how he wins his draw. I love the way he's down on that. He got a good draw there.
He's right on the blade.
Look at Maloney. He carries the puck. Where are the North Stars? And then they're wide open here. Oh. The defense is so wide open. And Fatorik had an easy. Well, I wouldn't say an easy shot, but a beautiful shot.
2 minutes to go. Face off in the North Stars end. They're down 4-1. And come down the right side. Cicerelli. Duguay did some holding at the blue line to slow up that drive. Cicerelli again. Puts a line in ahead. And the game has changed, obviously, here with the Rangers with a 3-goal lead. Good pass off. Shot. Save. Rebound. It must be behind the net. It was a fast whistle.
Dill blew the whistle and the puck is behind the net.
I think he thought it was underneath Beaupre.
Mike Allison is very angry and I don't blame him. Watch this little pass by Duguay. Right to Allison. Allison comes in. He has a great chance. He flips it up. Beaupre makes the save. Now the puck is loose. And it's behind the net. And you can see the puck behind the net. And watch Allison. He's very angry right now. He's angry with himself for missing the goal.
Uh-oh.
And he's angry.
Oh, Mike did made a mistake. He must have thrown the puck into the crowd.
That's what he probably did. He was angry at himself for missing it, but he's also angry because he haven't played that much tonight. And, you know, he was out there in a shift, got a good chance, and as soon as he heard the whistle, he saw the other guys coming over the boards, Mark Pavlich's line. And that's discipline right there. You just have to have the discipline in your body. I know what Mike is going through.
Petillo came over and patted him on the head.
That's right.
And so did Hedberg. Hedberg did the same thing.
And that's what I like, boy.
The whole team's coming over.
That's right, because they know that he is a little angry and...
See, that's the one of the penalties that no referee can ever ignore when everybody sees it happen.
That's right.
I saw Mike throw his hand. I didn't realize he had the puck in it. I thought he was just waving his arm in disgust. Apparently, threw it into the crowd.
He was frustrated at the referee first for blowing the whistle. The puck was loose because that meant the other guys are changing. He had to go off the ice. And I want a player on my team who's hungry to play.
You probably diagnosed it about right.
Oh, no, I know that one, Jim, because I've done the same thing. Believe me, I have. When I was his age and I was playing in the Chicago, I used to get pulled off every draw.
Kidding.
Oh, no, I never was allowed to take a faceoff. But Billy Ray wouldn't let me.
1:25 to go in the game. Power play will end it up for Minnesota. Beck bangs it off the boards. Kept in by Maxwell. Maxwell here, dead on shot. Can't find an opening in front. Score! And it's 4-2, and that won't make Allison feel any better about anything.
It sure won't.
1:12 to go.
Brad Maxwell scores here. I don't know what happened on this, so let's see if we can see. He just flipped it, and I think it hit somebody in front of the net. Let's watch. There it is. A little deflection. I believe it was Timmy Young who deflected that and went into the net. 4-2 now, Rangers. Minute and 12 seconds left. The best thing Mike Allison can do is just prove everyone wrong.
They're giving this to Maxwell. Well, it's unofficial anyway. Here's a quick shot high off the glass. That was McClanahan's shot. Rangers leading 4-2, 1 minute to go. Bellows tried to break and could not. They're trying to pull the goaltender out. Rangers had the puck. Beaupre has to stay in. The Rangers are going to have a possibility here. Almost on. Little knuckleball went wide. 48 seconds to go. Maxwell to the red line. Beaupre goes for his bench. Long shot by Smith. Save. Almost lost it. It took a dip to his ankle. 39 seconds to go. Stars continuing to fight. Open net. Bouncing puck. It will not get there. 30 seconds to go in the game. Open net. Baker plays it ahead, stopped before the red line. Maxwell with 20 seconds to go into the Rangers' end. 18 seconds to go. Dory ahead. It is cleared by the Rangers, and it'll just about waste the clock. North Stars will have a chance for one more shot toward net, maybe. 5 seconds to go. There's the shot. Wide. Game will end in two. It is over. Eddie Meehl does a good job. And so do most of the Rangers on this game. They played well against one of the hottest teams in the National Hockey League and one of the teams with the best young legs in the business. So, at the end of the game, the Rangers come away with a 4-2 victory over the Minnesota North Stars. Final score is 4-2. Stay tuned for the Rangers post-game show. And this is Madison Square Garden Cablevision.